We know the height reached by our bullet, and we can now compute the downward movement of the bullet using this height and zero velocity as our initial condition. We cannot, however, reuse the analytical results of the upward movement because now gravitational and frictional force do not point in the same direction. We will, however, obtain a separable differential equation, only the resulting integrals will be different. So let us take a look in this video. What will be the final velocity of our bullet? So bullet going down, m times a, gravity is still downward, but now friction upward because we're going down. Starting at zero velocity, we'll just reset the time. So dvdt equals, again, minus g, but now a minus sign over here instead of a plus sign, as we saw in the previous video. And we can, again, rewrite this in terms of V equilibrium, which is about 29 meters per second, as dvdt equals minus g times 1 minus now V squared over V equilibrium squared. Of course, we still have a separable differential equation, so we separate V's on the left and T's on the right. Integration of the right-hand side is trivial, but the one on the left-hand side is now not an arctangent anymore, but something else. We'll have to separate the fraction as A over 1 minus V equilibrium plus B over 1 plus V over V equilibrium. Multiply the first term with 1 plus V over V equilibrium and the other term with 1 minus V over V equilibrium to compute A and B. So we observe that the term with the V's has to be 0, so A minus B has to be 0. And the terms with the 1's here, A plus B has to be equal to this 1 over here, so A plus B equals 1. So A equals B, so 2A equals 1, so A equals 1 half equals B, so A and B are both 1 half. So then we integrate, we take the 1 half in front, we get the 1 over 1 minus V equilibrium and the 1 over 1 plus V over V equilibrium equals integral on the right hand side. Well, this integral is trivial. Integral on the left-hand side, we have to be a bit careful. First term gives us the log of 1 minus V over V equilibrium with the 1 half and a minus V equilibrium. And the other one similarly, but with a plus sign. We want to solve for V, of course. So we combine both logarithms into one log on the left-hand side and divide by V equilibrium and multiply with minus 2 to get rid of this constant here. So we get minus 2 gt over V equilibrium and some other constant over there. Let's, for ease of notation, call the factor in front of the t alpha. So the alpha equals 2g over V equilibrium. We want to have positive alpha, so leave the minus sign. Which means that if you take logarithms, we get so if you take exponentials, we get 1 plus V over V equilibrium over 1 minus V over V equilibrium equals the exponential of this one. Exponential minus alpha t plus c tilde equals exponential minus alpha t times exponential c tilde, and call the exponential c tilde d, new constant. And you can simplify the left-hand side also a bit. Plug in the initial condition, that t equals 0, you will have a 0 velocity. So if you plug in 0 velocity, we get a 1 over here. We get a 1 over here, so d also has to be equal to 1. So then we find V equilibrium plus V over V equilibrium minus V equals e to the power minus alpha t, where alpha is some constant that we know. Now, finally, solve for V. So V equilibrium plus V, bring this one to the other side, equals the exponent times V equilibrium minus V. Now bring this V to the left and the V equilibrium to the right. So we get V times 1 plus e to the power minus alpha t equals constant times minus 1 plus e to the power minus alpha t. And divide this one to get an expression for V. Now you see, if this t is much bigger than 1 over alpha, then t over alpha is a very negative number. And you see already what's going on. V will be equal to minus V equilibrium in this limit. So that's what you would intuitively expect. If you would go on a long time, at a certain point, your velocity has increased so far that gravity, increased so far that gravity counteracts the frictional force, so you are at your equilibrium velocity. Now, we have our expression for v as a function of t. Now, the only thing what we need to do is to compute t final, except t final equals zero using the expression for your velocity. Well, as it turns out, that's what we'll do in the second part of the video. This t final is approximately 10 seconds. And then you can plug in your t final and your expression for your velocity. And you'll see we're already in the limit that we are then at minus 29 meters per second. We are already in the limit that we are almost at V equilibrium at the final. Now, is this realistic? Well, you are very high, you start at zero velocity, takes 10 seconds to fall. It's more or less fine. If you would get several hours here, you know you are wrong. And if you get milliseconds again, you know that you're wrong. But 10 seconds will be approximately fine. And also makes sense intuitively that you reach more or less your equilibrium velocity. Now, for the second part of the video, we integrate our v in order to find our t final analytically. So, how do we do that? Well, first we rewrite a bit. V equilibrium, we add and subtract a factor of e to the power minus alpha t, so you get here e to the power minus alpha t with a minus sign and one more with a plus sign, because then we get minus 1 plus e to the power minus alpha t over 1 plus e to the power minus alpha t, giving you a minus 1 plus some other term. Then we can compute x of t, initial height plus integral from 0 to t, v dt, where we use as integration variable now d tall. Integrating minus 1 from 0 to t is trivial, it's just a constant, so this gives you a minus v equilibrium times t. And then you can take out the t in the v equilibrium for the other integral, which looks slightly awkward. However, you can use a substitution rule, for example, put e to the power minus alpha t equal to u, your substitution rule, to find the antiderivative over here, as we will see in the next slide. Which gives you, after putting back what alpha is, an expression for your height. So how did we do the integral? So we use the substitution rule, u equals e to the power minus alpha tau, so du equals alpha minus alpha times e to the power minus alpha tau d tau. So you get a du from here, a 1 plus u, and a minus 1 alpha over alpha from the substitution rule. For u equal, for t tall equals 0, you have u equals 1 in the lower boundary, and for tall equals t, you get e to the power minus alpha t in the upper boundary. But now your integral is trivial, you just get the ln of 1 plus u, upper boundary gives you the ln of 1 plus e to the power minus alpha t, lower boundary the ln of 2. You can simplify this to this expression over here, which gives us the height as a function of t. Now, you still, this looks awkward. It looks like a transcendental equation if you want to solve it. X of t final equals 0, so you have to put this right hand side to 0 and find the t, but you have t's over there and over there. This looks undoable. So if you do some numerical solver, you find your final time to be approximately 10 seconds. And your final velocity to be minus 29 meters per second. But the nice part is, that's the last trick of this video, that you can in fact solve this horrible equation here analytically as well. So, how can you solve it for t final? Multiply by g over v equilibrium squared to get rid of this part. Set this to 0 and put this to the right hand side. Then you get this expression over here. Then you take exponentials on left and right. Here we have some exponential, which is just a constant. Exponential gt of v equilibrium, and here e to the power ln. Now, of course, those e to the power ln cancels out. So the second part simplifies a bit. And then you see everywhere e to the power gt of v equilibrium gives you e to the power gt over v equilibrium plus e to the power minus gt over v equilibrium over 2. And a constant number on the right hand side, on the left hand side. Well, set this left hand side equal to a, and set this e to the power gt over v equilibrium equal to p. We want to solve p. What you get is a equals p plus 1 over p over 2. And that is just a quadratic equation. You get 2ap equals p squared plus 1, so p squared minus 2ap plus 1 equals 0. You can complete the square, p minus a squared plus 1 equals 0. Put a squared and a 1 to the right hand side, so p minus a squared equals a squared minus 1. And a is bigger than 1, it's the exponential of some positive number, so a squared minus 1 is positive. So p equals p minus with the minus, or p equals p plus with the plus sign. Now you are, now you need, which one do you need? The one, the p minus or the p plus? Well, p has to be bigger than 1. And you see that the product of those p pluses and p minus, if you take the product here, you get something of the form alpha minus beta times alpha plus beta equals alpha squared minus beta squared. So you get a squared minus a squared minus 1, so get a 1, so the product equals 1. Well, the p minus is smaller than 1, so and the p plus is bigger than 1. So you need 1 which is bigger than 1, so you need a p plus. So finally, there we are. Your p equals e to the power gt final over v equilibrium equals a plus squared of a squared minus 1. So you can solve for your t final in terms of v equilibrium and g and of a, and your constant a contains your g, your h naught, your initial height, and your v equilibrium. So you can plug in all the numbers and you find your t final of about 10 seconds. So what happens if you fire your bullet upward? Well, your bullet will travel to a height of about 200 meters. After 4.5 seconds, it starts to fall down, reaches equilibrium speed of about 100 kilometers an hour and hits you in your head. So you probably shouldn't try this at home because it still has a reasonable high speed.